Welcome to another of the Reliance SCADA HMI video series. Today, we are focusing on connecting a Modbus device to the Reliance system. Before getting started, let's take a look at some important facts. Modbus is one of the most widely used industrial communications protocols for connecting millions of devices worldwide. As a result of the use of new technologies, this open protocol has been continuously developed since its publication in 1979. Using the Modbus protocol, data can be transferred between devices over various networks and buses. The Modbus protocol standard defines the basic framework of functions. However, because the definition is not strict, it offers manufacturers a large degree of freedom to create their own special functions. On the one hand, it is okay. But on the other hand, it means that there is no single universal driver for reading data from any Modbus device. Modbus communication driver is intended for communication between Reliance's runtime software and Modbus control systems. The driver is able to read data from all devices compliant with the Modbus protocol standard. In addition, support for special functions can be added to the Reliance system. Here is a list of devices for which, in addition to standard communication functions of the Modbus protocol, some special functions are implemented. As you will see later, these subtypes can be specified after adding a device of type Modbus in the device manager. In the Reliance system, Modbus communication driver supports both types of communication: Modbus TCP for communication over Ethernet, and Modbus RTU for communication over a serial line. It is good to know that by purchasing a license for Modbus communication driver, you can use both types of communication at the same time. Here is a list of all supported communication functions of the Modbus protocol in the client mode. What is important is that the functions can be enabled or disabled for each device. It means that, for example, if you want to connect a device that does not support function 15, writing multiple digital outputs, simply disable this function and enable function 05 instead, writing a single digital output. In addition to the client mode, the Reliance system allows activating the server mode for a Modbus device. In such a case, Modbus communication driver does not read data from this device, but it allows, via the Modbus TCP protocol, another client to read and write data from or to this device over Ethernet. Here is a list of all supported communication functions in the server mode. In the Reliance system, the address of a tag defined within a Modbus device consists of a register type and an address, while memory areas of a different type in a modicon device are addressed using an offset, tags in the Reliance system are addressed from 0 for each register type. For example, holding registers 40001 in modicon is equal to holding registers 0 in Reliance. In today's example, we'll be connecting Reliance to a Modbus PLC and displaying the value of a tag. We will also be showing you some of the settings we've just mentioned. First, we'll create a new project in Reliance Design. Then, we'll open the Device Manager and add a device of type Modbus. After that, we will configure communication, define a tag, connect the Modbus device to the computer, place a display and a container in the visualization window, and connect the display to the tag. The container will allow us to view communication with the PLC. Finally, we will of course run the project to make sure everything works all right. So, let's get started. We must first run the Reliance Design development environment and create a new project. Let's name it Modbus Connection. We must confirm the settings in the Create New Project wizard and the Create New Window wizard. Now, let's go to the Manager's menu, open the Device Manager, click on New Device, and choose the Modbus device type. By default, this type of device allows connecting models communicating via the standard Modbus protocol. However, we can also choose one of the supported models that requires special handling. In our example, a PLC communicating via the standard Modbus TCP protocol is connected. And here, its IP address must be set. For the purpose of our example, we will be using Modbus simulator running on the same computer, so the address is 127.0.0.1. If your Modbus device does not support any of these functions, it can be disabled. We need to create a new tag named HR100, set its data type to Word, register type to Holding Registers, and address to 100. We need to confirm the settings by pressing OK. Now, let's confirm connecting the device to the computer. Choose the network Ethernet channel type and set the communication protocol to TCP/IP. This option allows us to activate the server mode if needed. We must not forget to save the changes. Once the Modbus device is defined, a display component can be added to the visualization window. We must double-click to open the component's property editor. Let's go to the Functions page to specify a link to the tag. To change the tag's value during runtime, we must go to the Security page and activate the Enable Setting Value option. Now, we can also add a container component to the window where we will select the respective communication channel. We do not need a container for communication with the Modbus PLC, but it will allow us to view the communication. Lastly, we can run the project. The display is showing us the tag value and, in the container, we can see how Reliance is communicating with the PLC. Reading data from the PLC is shown in green. Now, let's change the tag value. As you can see, the write operation is shown in magenta.